Hey everyone, welcome back to the Bird Brain Gaming Coin Series. Today I'm going to look through $115 of half dollar coins. I have $30 worth of quarters and I have 5 mystery coins. This envelope right here, I went to one of my local banks and the clerk gave me $20 of coins, 15 of which are half dollars, and she pulled out 5 extra coins that I actually do not own. So we're gonna check this out after I do the quarters. I'm gonna search through the quarters first, see if we could find any low mints, any 2009s, 10s, 11s, I believe some 12s that are low mintage, any pre-65s, or any obvious errors, any W quarters, any San Francisco proof quarters. And then when I'm done with those, I'm gonna go through these rolls and I'm gonna go through this envelope as well. So let's see what we find today. All right, I have 3 customer wrapped rolls here. They're all customer wrapped and they might be previously searched. I'm not too certain. This is how I received them. This roll right here is taped. I don't know if they were previously searched through or not. So we're gonna find out regardless. If I see any NIFCs, not intended for circulation coins, I'll pull those out as well from the half dollars. Obviously I'm gonna look for silvers, any San Francisco proofs, any low mint 1987s of any letter on them, whether it's Philly, Denver, anything else, doesn't matter. I'm probably gonna do the envelope right after these quarters because I'm anxious to see what's inside. So let's start on these quarters. These are all customer wrapped. So any 2009s, 10s, 11s, especially 12s. There are 3 quarters, 3 types of quarters for 2012 that are really low mint. The El Yunque from Puerto Rico, the Chaco Culture National Historical Park quarter, and the Acadian National Park quarters. Those are all really low mintage, 25 million copies and under. And I believe there's one in 2013 that's low mint. The White Mountain National Forest, the 2013 Philadelphia version of that quarter is 68 million. So I'm gonna pull those quarters out. And as I said, the 2009s, 10s, 11s, I'll pull out as well. We have a 2011 Olympic quarter here. This is a low mint. Olympic 2011 Denver 30.6 million, really low mint. So I'm gonna keep that. If I find anything good, I'll pull them out and I'll bring you back. Okay, I'm on roll number 2. Found this bicentennial. Alright, I found in roll number 2 a 2010 Hot Springs, a Philadelphia Mint, 2010 Hot Springs. This is a low mintage quarter. There are only 35.6 million copies of this quarter. That's really low. Okay, got roll number 3 of quarters, and after this roll, I'm gonna move on to the envelope, and we're gonna see what's inside. Just found a 2013 White Mountain Philadelphia Mint, 68.6 1.8 million copies of this one. If it's under 100 million, I'd recommend you hang on to it. Alright, the quarters are done. I found four quarters that I'm going to show you at the very end. Right now, let's check out what's inside this envelope. What do we have here? Oh wow. Holy crap. Look at this. Got an Eisenhower $1 coin. Oh, that's awesome. So I don't currently own Eisenhowers. Since I've been doing coin collecting and searching, I never really asked for Eisenhowers, but when I went to the bank recently, the teller said she had these five $1 coins. I'm like, just throw them in with the half dollars. And I didn't really get a good look at them until now. I got two bicentennials, a 71, a 74, and a 72 Eisenhower $1 coin. So these are the five coins that were thrown in. That's so cool. Here's the back of the coins. These are the bicentennials with the Liberty Bell on them. That's so cool. I finally got to own some Eisenhowers. Alright, so I'm going to keep all these five. Let's move on to the half dollars, see what we could find. Okay, let's see what we have in this first $15 of Kennedy's. These were in the envelope. Right off the bat, this one caught my eye. Let's see what year this is. This one's in really good shape. This looks like a more modern. More modern half dollar. Yeah, it looks really good. What year is this? 2022 Philly. This is a not intended for circulation half dollar. There are approximately 4.8 million copies of this coin in circulation. The 2022 Philadelphia half dollars. Really extremely low mintage. That's cool. This one I'm definitely keeping. All right, let's keep looking, see what else I find. Philly. 87s I'm looking out for. Those are low mint. Denver 95. Not seeing anything else. 85. 88. Alright, so I'm gonna go on to the next roll of halves. Let's check out this one opened bank wrapped roll. This is the only one. The rest are all customer wrapped. I don't mind searching pre-searched rolls because sometimes I could pull out a coin that was overlooked, like a NIFC, an error coin, anything like that, because you can always still find something. Okay, let's see what we got. The bicentennials I'll keep as well. I do like to keep those. Looks like we got a, is that a silver? Yep. We got a silver. 1969. Silver, half dollar. 40% silver. These 40% silvers go for about $6-ish on average. If you could get the 64s and older, they'll be about $12 or more. There's another bicentennial. Got another NIFC. So this 92, nope, right here, this one. Look at this baby. 2021 Philadelphia NIFC. There are 2.3 million copies of this coin. So about four more coins in. I should have just let the camera roll. I got 2016. A mint. Looks like a Denver Mint 2016. Yep. There are 2.1 million copies of this coin. 2.1 million. 2016 Denver. Keeping that one. Got a bicentennial. I got several bicentennials already, so I'm going to pull all those out. Roll number 8 is taped. So let's get this open. Let's see what's inside. Looks like we got something. What do you think? This one right here, and one right here. Let's check this one out. $19.67, 40% silver. Beautiful. I'll take it. And the other one, this one. This one caught my eye. Let's see what year it is. 1968. Yep. Another 40%er. That's 3 40% or so far, 268 and one, actually 69, 68 and 67 so far. All right, let's see what else is in this roll. Bicentennial. Whoa, holy crap, we got a 64 in here. That one just escaped me. Look at this one. 1964, 90% silver. I thought this was a clad coin from the side, so I just overlooked that one. definitely take this one. This is about a $12-ish coin right here. Awesome. Got a bicentennial. Looks like somebody took a bite out of it. Some of these are in pretty good shape. There's another bicentennial. Holy crap. We got another 40% of here that I overlooked. It looks a little bit reddish on the side. That's why I just looked past it. Yep, 1968. It looks like a Denver. Yep, there's the D right in the center. Awesome, 40% right here. So we got four silvers in this row. So now we have 268s. Alright, let's move on to the next row. Let's see what we find. So far we're doing pretty good. Alright, let's see what we got in the final row. And then I'll do a recap of everything we got today. Alright, I'm not seeing any obvious silvers. Alright, I'm done sorting through the quarters and the halves. I laid out everything that I found. I'm going to be keeping all of these right here. Let's start off on top. I found 23 Philly minted bicentennials. This one can almost pass off as a silver, but it's not. It's clad. I also got 8 Denver minted bicentennials. The 3 NIFCs that I found. First one, 2016 Denver. 2.1 million copies of that coin. As you can see right in my book. 2016D, 2.1 million. Also, 2021 Philly and 2022 Philly and IFCs, one of each. The 2021 Phillies, 2.3 million copies. And the 2022 Phillies I mentioned before, it's not listed in my book as of this edition, but it's roughly around the same amount, maybe a little bit higher. I also found silvers, 5 silver half dollars. Got a 1969. Looks like a Denver. Let's get a closer look. Yep, 1969. Looks like a D right over that 6 in between. Also got a 1968 D and another 1968 D. Let me double check these. Yeah, those are Denvers. Then I got a 1967 Philadelphia. There's no mint mark. These are all 40 percenters. They're about $6-ish, around that price range, $6 each. And then a 1964 Philadelphia. This one's 90% silver. There's no mint mark on it, so it's a Philly. Check the back. cool. It's been a while since I found some silvers and half dollar rolls. Because in my area, the banks don't give boxes. You can't order. I have to ride my bike really far to place orders to get them. So for now, I just hunt them in my area, whatever the tellers have at the banks. I always request half dollars. Also, one of the banks I went to had some Eisenhower dollars. I got two bicentennials here. They look like Philly mints. These are the very first Eisenhowers I've ever owned. I have a 71, a 72, and a 74. Check the back. I know these are just common ones, but I'm happy to own them anyway since I've never had any of them. And two bicentennials, here's the back. Got the Liberty Bell. As for the quarters that I found, the low mintage quarters, starting off, Philadelphia minted White Mountain from 2013. This has a mint of 68.8 million copies, which is pretty low. For 2011, Olympic. This one is a Philly, I believe. Let me double check the front. Denver Mint. So an Olympic from 2011, Denver Mint. There we go. 2011D Olympic. 30.6 million copies. Right here, this one, Philly Mint, Philadelphia Mint, 2010 Hot Springs. If you see those, hang on to them. 2010 P Hot Springs National Park, 35.6 million copies. 2011 the bicentennial quarter. I always hang on to the bicentennial quarters and I make full rolls of those just for fun. I know there's tons of them, but I just like to make rolls. All right, let's check my scale. We're gonna find out the weight of these silvers. Starting off with the 69, 11.5. 47 grams. The silvers are usually heavier than the clads. Let's check out the first 68. 11.46 grams. Let's check out the other 68. 11.33 grams. This one's slightly lighter. Let's check out the 1967. 11.36 grams, and the final coin for today, the 1964, 90% silver, 12.41 grams. All right, so that does it for today's episode. If you liked what you see, smash that like button, subscribe, leave a comment if you like, and I'll see you all next time. I'm Bird Brain Gaming. Later, everyone. In the still of the night.